Hi, everybody. Welcome to another week of St. Luke's Little Church. Thanks for joining us again. This week is the 31st Sunday in Ordinary Time, Year B. Okay, let's start with our prayer. So hands together, and we'll say, let's say the Hail Mary this week because we've been practicing it and we're coming to the end of the month of October of the Lady of the Rosary. Ready? In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death, amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. All right, are we ready to sing our song before we listen to the gospel?
Yeah.
Let's go. Listen, listen to God's word. God is speaking, he is here. Alleluia, sing his praise. Alleluia, hearts we raise. Fill us with your love. Send your spirit from above. That was great. Okay. Now, before we read the gospel, remember we need to cross ourselves. So, with your thumb, God be in my thoughts or in my mind, God be in my words, and God be in my heart. So now we're going to have the reading, just a reading from the Gospel of Mark. One of the scribes came to Jesus and asked, which of God's commandments is the most important? Jesus answered, to love God with all your heart and all your soul and all your mind and all your strength. And to love others as much as you love yourself. These commandments come before all others. Then the scribe said to Jesus, what you have said is true, because nothing is more important than loving God and loving our neighbors. Seeing that the scribe was wise and good, Jesus said to him, my friend, you are indeed close to God and his kingdom. Hearing this, no one dared ask Jesus any more questions. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Okay, Grace, so I wonder, can you remember who it was that asked the question to Jesus about what was the greatest commandment?
The scribe.
The scribe. Scribes were people who used to document and write, make note of things that had happened. So they used to keep records. Why did he ask Jesus this question?
Because he records information and needs to make sure that the information is correct.
And what did he really want to know? He wanted to know what was
the most important commandment.
He wanted to know, and he wanted to be able to write down what the greatest commandment was, which is the most important one. What did Jesus tell him?
He said, you need to love God with all your heart, mind, strength, and
soul,
and
body.
You need to love others as much as you love yourself.
That's right, to love others as much as you love God and yourself. Did the scribe agree? So when he gave him that answer, did he say, yep, that makes sense, or no, I don't agree?
He said, yes, I agree. That
he did, anybody else? Because then nobody asked him any more questions. That was the greatest commandment. So today we're going to do a little dance. We're not going to stand up. This is a new one. We're going to do a sitting down. We're just going to point where we need to point. But if you want to get up and you want to dance around the room, you can dance around the room. We might need to move out a little bit. You move that way a little bit first. That's it. And let's go.
We're going to be singing about how we love the Lord our God.
Christian lives too. stuck at home is no.
That got a little bit tricky, didn't it? But I think we did well. Hopefully you did well at home too. All right, that brings us to the end. We'd like you to keep in your minds, in your prayers and in your hearts, the children who are all preparing for their first reconciliation at the moment. We've also had the children who finished their Holy Communion preparation. They're getting ready to actually make their first Holy Communion. And, of course, we pray for all the children, the high school students who are doing their HSC. So let's finish up with the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there, he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body and the life everlasting. Amen. Thanks for joining us again today. We look forward to seeing you again next time. Have a great week. Bye.